Right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Terence Yap. He is the executive chairman of Guardforce AI. And Terence, it's good to have you along. How are you?
Steve, thank you very much. It's well, thank you.
Good. We got lots to talk about. But before we do that, just a quick little synopsis on Guardforce, just so everyone understands what it is that you do.
Well, we are really truly an integrated security provider. We have been around since 1982. So this year, we're also celebrating our 40th anniversary. So we have been serving our clients in Asia, providing them with security solutions like ATM, cash in transit, et cetera. But since 2019 onwards, we started to transform our business to go into more technology-related solutions like robotics, AI, and cybersecurity. And so we have been progressing relatively strong in terms of all those areas over the past 12 months.
Yeah. Now, Terence, you released your financial numbers. We'll deal with those in just a second because it really relates to some news that was out today, in fact. And I want to ask you quickly about that. And that is that you've announced your expansion into Dubai and Australia. So two pretty good markets for your company. Can you talk a bit more about this expansion?
Yes, it's part of our overall strategy of geographical expansion. In the beginning of this year or even last year, we actually started to go about expanding beyond where we are. We started with just Thailand, then we went to Singapore, and then we slowly went to Malaysia, Macau, and last week we actually announced acquisitions of a Chinese company. So now we are going to China, and we also announced our setup in the US as well. So the addition of Dubai and Australia adds our geographical reach to 9 different markets. Markets that we think will continue to grow as the pandemic situation evolves and as people and clients demand more automated solutions. Robotic solutions is here to stay. It's just how we become relevant to our clients. So Dubai itself is interesting because last year, Dubai actually mentioned that it become a smart Dubai city, and whereby investing a lot in terms of innovation and technology and AI. So I think we fit very well in terms of how we want to support that development. And similarly in Australia as well. Australia is an interesting country because it's got a huge geographical reach. The consumers there are all very well educated and it's moving towards automation as well. So we are extremely excited with this new addition to our geographical reach.
Yeah. Let's talk about those financial numbers that I mentioned, because what they really showed was, and I think it's something you talked about in 2018, 2019, 2020, is really that transition that you saw. And last year was a big part of that as well. You did raise a lot of money, which obviously is a positive. But the fact is you really set yourself up for 2022. Is that a fair assessment of them?
And that's a very accurate assessment of it. 2021 was a very busy year for us. We did a lot in terms of market expansion. We delivered a lot in terms of going about deploying robots. And we actually announced that we deployed surpass the 1,400 robotics deployment regionally. So that was a very exciting milestone for us. So certainly 2021 was a year that we actually acquired a cybersecurity company. It was also a year that we uplisted onto NASDAQ. And so you're right, we actually raised the money to help us expand the business. And so moving forward, we think there's a huge opportunity for us to grow the business even more. And we have guided that in 2022, we will be looking at $55 to $60 million in terms of the top line revenue. And the bulk of it, probably about $21 million or representing about 36% of our total revenues in 2022 will be from acquisition. So we will continue to expand the geographical reach and also the depth and reach of our business.
And Terence, one last question, and that is, just to back up what we talked about at the beginning for Dubai and Australia, are you hoping to realize some revenue in this year as well, or do you need time to set things up within those two countries? How will that work, or would that be substantial in your growth this year also?
Not this year. Those are the flag planting efforts that we have done. Yeah. We think that the bulk of the revenues will still come from the region that we are. We are very confident of the US market. We are also very confident of the China market as well. But the planting of the flags are important for us.
Absolutely. Makes a lot of sense. Terence, congratulations on all this. Very exciting times for you and the company. And we really appreciate the time today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Steve.
All right. There's Terence Yap. He's the executive chairman of Guardforce AI.